Is the effort of Russian propaganda actors to just sow confusion, to make people doubt that anything could be true?
Sure, yeah. I mean, that is the main goal of Russian disinformation, whether it be through their television channels, whether it be through other measures like hacking, like legions of paid trolls. That is the ultimate goal, is to undermine democracy, to undermine faith in our institutions like the media. And we have a president-elect now who has basically matched some of these key talking points in Russian propaganda to undermine our system.
So let's go there directly. I mean, here's something that I've been asking myself. Julia, we're talking about a candidate who's lost in a historic way in terms of the popular vote, but clearly won in the Electoral College. Is this something of a national emergency? And are journalists afraid to say so because they're going to sound partisan?
I've been thinking about this because it does feel like we're on the verge of something potentially awful, and Trump seems to be taking us there daily with some of his cabinet picks, with his statements. You know, talk about sowing chaos. We have elected, you know, the chaos sower in chief. You know, undermining the validity of intelligence reports, undermining the work of the press, of various government institutions, democratic institutions. So, but on the other hand, I feel like we've been reporting on this all along, but A, people don't read us, because I remember going out into the country talking to voters, and people would tell me their main news sources were YouTube, Facebook, and word of mouth. You saw BuzzFeed did an excellent story on fake news and how much traffic they get, and how much more traffic each of these false news stories gets than New York Times stories and Washington Post stories. So we're writing about it, but A, people aren't listening, and B, they don't believe us. Well, and also, I think, I'm sorry, the one other thing is that the press has been leaning on the panic button for about a year with Donald Trump, and I think it's kind of the boy who cried Trump, and now Trump is here, and people are like, I think people are exhausted by the election and by all the negativity of it, and are like, whatever, let's just move on, even though it's only getting worse.
David, sure. Russian interference in an election, is this a crisis? Is this a national emergency?